Hello everyone. In continuation with the Fourier series, we'll be starting with the Fourier series expansions. Under this, we'll be going ahead with the period 2 pi. So there are different combinations and different functions where this 2 pi function, period 2 pi is given. So I have divided this Fourier series expansions of period 2 pi as in different parts. Parts as in algebraic functions, if the function has been exponential function, if it is given in piecewise or it is in trigonometric function and so on. So let us go ahead. So by the end of the session, you'll be able to evaluate the Fourier series with period 2 pi. So the example is find the Fourier series of f of x is being given by this particular function in the interval 0 to 2 pi and hence deduce. Okay. So let us first consider on so we will divide this part. This is the first part of the question and this is the second part of the question. So that means my first part is I need to find out the Fourier series expansion. Okay. Before that, just let us concentrate on this 0 to 2 pi. If I will compare this 0 to 2 pi with c to c plus 2l, this is the interval what we have taken up in the last session where I have given you the Euler's theorem or Euler's formula with this c to c plus 2l. And if I'll compare this 0 to 2 pi, what is my requirement here? So here, if I compare this, so comparing will give me this and it will give me this. So that means I'll get it c equals to 0 and I'll get it c plus 2l is 2 pi, which is l is nothing but equals to pi. So this is very important to understand this, what is the value of L, because in the Euler's formula what we have taken cos of n pi x by L. So everywhere the understanding of that L is very important. And according to that, so this is the Fourier series expansion where this is cos of n pi x by L was there. So L is pi here. So pi and this n, this pi will go off from here from the angle and will remain here with cos of nx. Now, what is our target? Our target is to find out a0, to find out an, and to find out bn for this to get the Fourier series expansion. Okay, so they are the constants. a0 is equals to 1 upon 2 pi, 0 to 2 pi f of x dx. For this formula, please refer the previous session where we have already discussed about what is the Euler's formula and how this Euler's formula will move according to the value of L and according to the interval. So a0 is 1 upon 2 pi 0 to 2 pi f of x dx. So we are just putting this value of f of x, that is this 3x square minus 6x pi plus 12, 2 pi square upon 12. Then just the integration of this particular function. So it's 12 is a constant, so it is outside because the variable here in this case is x. X is the variable of the integration. Therefore, 1 upon 24 pi is a constant. Then x square. So x square integration will give me x cube by 3. Here x is there, so it's x square by 2. And this is, there is nothing here. So this will give me x. Then we will put the upper limit and the lower limit here. After putting the upper limit and lower limit, so now if that means what? We will be putting x is equals to 2 pi and x is equals to pi over here in each and every term. So upper limit minus the lower limit. So if you'll observe, if I'm putting x is equals to 2 pi everywhere, we'll be getting it 8 pi cube by 3. This is 4 pi square by 2. Of course, these other constants are present there. And this x, it will be giving me 2 pi into 2 pi square will give me 4 pi cube. What will happen? Minus lower limit here. So minus lower limit, because of the x present each and every term here and x we are replacing as 0, so the minus the lower term would give me 0, and therefore the answer for this particular is equals to 0. Why this answer is coming out to be 0? You can just easily cross check from here. What I am doing it, just check it out. It's 8 pi cube plus 4 pi cube will give me 12 pi cube minus this 12 pi cube will give me 0, and therefore a square a 0 is equals to 0. What is a n? The formula says it's 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi f of x cos of nx dx. Therefore we are just putting the value over here. Now what will happen here, because of its LIATE rule, this 3x square minus 6x pi plus 2 pi square, that is a numerator because it's 12, will come out of this bracket. So this is the first function. right? This is the first function and this is the second function. Now in the first step, first function as it is, right? And the second function, the derivative of that function. So what, sorry, integration of this cos of nx. Cos of nx will give me, let me just take it out for a while. So first function as it is into integration of the second will give me sine of nx upon n. Now this first and the second function, the role will be changed by these two functions. Okay. And then what will happen? The differentiation minus differentiation of this first function, which is 6x minus 6 pi into integration of the second will give us sine nx upon n, which is minus of cos of nx upon n square. Now, moving to the next step, I don't want this as first. This has been replaced as this function, and the role of second function has been replaced by this function now. And that is why we are calling it as a musical chair. Please refer the previous what we have discussed in the Laplace transform. 6x minus 6 pi minus cos of nx upon n square. Now first function plus over here. It's a plus here, minus here, right? And now plus over here. So this will give me first function. The derivative of the first function is 6 here. Integration of the second will get it as minus sine of nx upon n cube. Integration is from 0 to 2 pi. What will happen? Now this is not the first, now this is not the second. Now 6 is the first function and this is the second function. What is the next step? Next step onwards we'll be getting at 0, because this is the differentiation of the first function will give me 0. And therefore the on other terms we need not to calculate or we need not to write down. So we have just not written that. What will happen in the next, if I'll put the upper limit and the lower limit, let me write down here. So it's 1 by 12 pi upper limit. So whenever I'm writing the upper limit, every term would be replaced here as 2 pi. What is this? This is x is equals to 2 pi and x is equals to pi, 0 here. So whenever we are putting x is equals to 2 pi, it will give us this 3. So it's a, let me just put it up that way, 3 into 2 pi square minus 6 into 2 pi into pi plus 2 pi square, right? Now this is the first term, but because we have got it here sine and x, and if I will put it here x as 2 pi, I'm going to get sine of 2 n pi, and it is always 0. Always it is 0, right? Therefore, what will happen whenever I'm putting the upper limit as 2 pi, this term will give me here 0. Because whenever I'm putting this x as 2 pi, it will give me sine 2 pi, which is equals to 0. And therefore, this term, this first term, whenever I'm putting 2 pi, will give me 0. What will happen in the next step? It is minus 6 into 2 pi. So it's 6 into 2 pi minus 6 pi into minus of cos of n. So cos of 2 n pi upon n square, right? And what will happen here again? The same case arises here because it's a sine nx, and because of this, this term will give me 0 as we have seen it here. So that this term won't come here. So plus, you can say write down 0. So this has, we have done it, the upper limit. So this is the upper limit here, right? And this 12 is there in the 1 upon 12 pi is there with everything here. Minus, what will happen with the minus when I am putting every x as 0? Again, this we will not concentrate on this here. First, let us concentrate in sine of nx. If I am putting sine of 0, so this again will give me sine of 0 as equals to 0. Because of that, this term will give me 0 here. Similarly, this term will get it as 0. So we have to just deal with the middle term whenever we are putting x is equals to 0. Clear? So therefore, the first term is 0. Minus, I am putting every x as 0. So it will give me minus of 6 pi. Minus of cos of 0 upon n square. And the next term will also be 0. So this is the lower limit for this, and this is the bigger term. And this entire thing has been explained you here, and that is why this is the in-between step I would like to explain you all. That is the reason I have did not written it here. After the simplification, So this is the term here. This is a 6 pi because it's a 12 pi minus 6 pi will give me 6 pi, but with the minus sign. So I have got this one minus sign here, and sorry, this minus sign here, and this is another minus sign. So therefore, it is a plus over here. Plus, and this is cos of 2n pi by n square. This is the term. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 terms as negative. So this becomes here positive actually. This is minus minus. Obviously, this is minus minus plus. You'll get it here. And therefore, it's cos of n pi. What is this reason? The same reason I have given you here. Cos of 2n pi is equal to sine 0. Sorry, sine of 2n pi is equal to sine 0 is 0. And after simplification, further, you'll get this as. So which is nothing but this result arise from cos of 2n pi is equals to cos of 0 is equals to 1. And therefore, we'll be getting the answer for this an. So therefore, we have got it an as 1 upon n square just by simplification. Similarly, for bn, the same thing we will be doing it. Again, we'll go for first and the second function, then putting the upper limit and the lower limit. So if I wanted to have it here, the in-between step, right, in between step here, what will happen here, because of this 2 pi, so I'm putting x is equals to 2 pi and x is equals to 0. Let me just concentrate on the sine term. Whenever I will put sine here, this term, this will give me 0 for x is equals to pi also, x is equals to 2 pi also, and for x is equals to 0 also, this will give me 0. Yeah. And what will happen whenever I'm not putting, so this is what in middle term will be getting it as 0 every time for x is equals to 2 pi as well as for x is equals to 0. Rest of the terms are, I have written it here. So the next step you can refer it from here. So x has been replaced as 2 pi and it's cos of 2 and pi and everything here. If you'll observe every term, every x will be replaced as 2 pi minus every x has been replaced as 0. This is the reason. And these are the steps what we have discussed in the previous. So my suggestion is take a pause here and try to get the answer on your own so that you will build up the confidence in you. The similar, because it's almost similar steps, only instead of sine and cos, we have got just a roll of that sine and cos flipped. Okay, and therefore, if you'll observe this entire thing, try to get the answer as 0. So we have got bn as equals to 0. Now this is the series. We have got it, this a0 as 0, and we have got it bn also equals to 0. Therefore, these two terms won't come. We have got this, the value of an as 1 upon n square, and therefore the Fourier series here becomes f of x is equals to summation of 1 upon n square cos of nx. Now, if I wanted to write down or expand this series, this will happen in f of x is, we have written the value of the function 3x square minus 6x pi plus 2 pi square upon 12. Now, what will happen with the summation? This summation will go as, what will be the value of this when n is 1, when n is 2, when n is 3 and so on. Now, if n is equals to 1, so I'm writing this n equals to 1. When n is equals to 1, it is 1 upon 1 square cos of x. So, this is the term. When n is equals to 1. When n is equals to 2, what will happen? 1 upon 2 squared cos of 2x. So this is the term when n is equals to 2. When n is equals to 3, n equals to 3, what will happen? It's 1 upon 3 squared cos of 3x. So this is the term for n equals to 3. And how many terms we have? We have got infinity terms. So that means what, this addition series or this series will go up to infinity. Normally Fourier series is always a infinite series. Now, this is, we have addressed to the first question, that is to find the Fourier series expansion of this function. This is what we have done it, address the first question. The second question here is this, that is a deduce this part. Now, if you'll observe this particular series, what we have got it here. If you'll observe, we have got it 1, right? It's cos. So, I want something here, the value of x, I need to choose the value of x from 0 to 2 pi in such a way that I will be getting from this Fourier series, I'll be getting this type of series. Okay, this type of expansion rather than. So what will be that? It's, if you observe, it's 1 here, 1 upon 2 square plus 1 upon 3 square plus 1 upon 4 square and so on. That means, in fact, what I needed this cos of x should be equals to 1. I need this cos of 2x has to be 1. I need cos of 3x has to be 1, right? So you need to understand the expansion and what is the demand of that particular x. So if you'll observe, if I will put x is equals to 0 in this particular series, both the sides, what will happen here? So it's x is equals to 0, so this will go from here, this will go from here, it will be 2 pi square by 6 by 12, which is pi square by 6 here. So we have got this side here, if you'll observe, we have got this. What will happen to the next side? Cos of x, that is cos of 0, cos of 2, 0, that is cos of 0 and cos of 3, 0. And we know that cos of 0 is always equals to 1. And that is the reason we have taken, we have considered the value of x is equals to 0. And we have got this particular thing, everything. And therefore, this is, we have addressed the second question as well, which is the deduction part. And this is what is known as the Fourier series expansion. Let me tell you first thing, that you need to have a lot of patience whenever you are solving the Fourier series expansion. Each and every step of the Fourier series expansion is very important. If you will miss out something in the first step, next step will obviously collapse, and hence the last Fourier series will not be correct. If this series will not be correct, obviously this deduction part will not be able to come into the picture. And that is why you need a lot of concentration and the patience while finding out the Fourier series expansion. I hope you have understood this particular question. We'll be stay tuned for the next session and next example. Thank you. Happy learning.